when I wake up in the morning, love, and the sunlight hurts my eyes, and something without warning, love, bears heavy on my mind. Then I look at you, and the world's all right with me. Just one look at you, and I know it's gonna be a lovely day.
Hey.
Did you get any sleep?
Not much.
I had terrible dreams.
Oh, did you?
Don't hate me. But I want you to say no to meeting this Andy Weston bloke.
It's my job.
It's not CID. They don't pay you enough to do manhunts and murderers.
I'm still a copper. Anyway, it was you that wanted me to look for new challenges.
Just think about it.
Doesn't it bother you? Being stuck in this sweaty box every day.
Not really.
It's tragic. You spend your whole life selling ice cream so other people can enjoy their time off in the sun. But we haven't had an holiday in 9 years.
Only flakes.
Did you not hear me?
Told you, we've got no time for holidays.
A weekend break, then?
You got a clogged nozzle or something? We're in peak season. Got to make every day count if we're to stay ahead of the competition.
Today if you need me. Rob?
It doesn't make sense.
Do you want me to phone the station and say you're sick?
No. I've got to do it. I just wish I knew who he was.
Well, you're a copper. You have run-ins with people all the time.
You think he's got a grudge?
I think he's been probably given your name as a good, honest copper who'll listen to his side of the story.
Mm. Oh, son.
Hi. Is the DCI driver in yet?
Sergeant Hollins?
Yes.
Superintendent Noakes. You're late.
By my watch. Sorry, sir, the traffic was awful. Is the DCI around?
DCI driver is suspended from duty.
When?
Yesterday.
Can I ask why, sir?
No, Sergeant, you can't.
I got a message about her suspect, Andy Weston. Said he would only speak to me.
Yes, I'm aware.
Yeah, you want me to talk to him? Sir, do you want me to speak to the suspect?
Not yet. Come to my office in an hour.
Still high, I'm afraid.
Some steps on the way up here.
Need to refer you to a cardiologist at St. Phil's.
Really?
Yes, I've been seeing you for a few weeks now. A few warning signs, nothing too alarming by themselves, but added together, you do need to take it seriously. How are you doing with the diet changes?
Well, it's hard to eat well when you're surrounded by ice cream all day.
Yes, it must be, but you do need to eat more healthily and avoid stressful situations.
Dr. Clay?
Yes.
Superintendent Noakes, are you busy?
Now?
Yes, now.
According to the log, I should be checking a flesh wound from a gunshot.
Andy Weston?
Hold on a sec. Yep, that's the one, but if it's just a case of redressing the wound, then it probably won't take long. What's the problem?
I'm sending Weston for a full psychiatric assessment, but I'd like you to do a preliminary evaluation. When he finished dressing his wound.
Okay. Is there any reason why you're checking his mental health?
Yes. Instead of unburdening his conscience to someone with actual qualifications, like a lawyer or me, he set his heart on speaking to Sergeant Rob Hollins. I don't know if you know Hollins.
Yes.
But I'm not letting Weston loose on a underqualified officer of questionable intelligence until we know exactly what we're dealing with.
Well, Sergeant Hollins is an excellent officer.
Well, I'm sure his handling of parking infringements is exemplary. One false move and Hollins could mess up this entire investigation.
He knows what he's doing.
It's a plot. You find out what's going on between Weston's ears. I'll find out if Hollins has got anything between his.
Do you have anything better to do?
I'm on strike. Not that you've realised. I could shave my head and you wouldn't notice for a week.
Strike?
I'm not lifting a finger until we book somewhere. Minimum 1 week, 4 or 5 stars, all inclusive.
All inclusive?
That till has been singing the last few months, so don't pretend we can't afford it. Remember when we first met? And you were working in that bottling factory. You told me how you'd love to be your own boss, be able to up and leave whenever you wanted. Well, now's your chance.
Totally.
And now I'm telling you, Rowan Jones, even a murderer gets time off for good behaviour, so don't push your luck. Now, what did he say?
Who?
Who do you think? The doctor.
Are they much?
I can tell when you're lying a mile off.
He's referring me.
Referring? Where?
Hospital.
Why? What does he think is wrong?
Don't get your knickers in a twist. It's just a few tests.
I've told you that you work too hard. This is exactly why we should...
Oh, power's gone. It's him.
Oh, don't do anything stupid.
Sit down. So, why you? Why has Weston asked to speak to you?
I don't know.
You'll have to do better than that.
It's the truth. I have no idea why he's asked for me.
No past dealings with him?
Never met the man. Never even heard of him, and I've just spent the last hour trawling through old arrest reports to see if his name pops up, and it doesn't.
Well, aren't you the fountain of ignorance? Okay, so let's assume, just for argument's sake, he's chosen you for some specific dastardly reason. I want to know what that reason is. So, tell me about yourself.
What do you want to know?
Everything.
Might be the early signs of an infection, so we need to keep an eye on that. Much pain?
Nothing a large whiskey wouldn't fix.
Can't help you there.
You don't tell anybody, I won't.
I can prescribe some painkillers and some maricillin.
What's that? You're not pumping me full of weird drugs.
No, it's antibiotics for the infection. It's just 500 milligrams, 4 times a day.
No, thanks. I'll take my chances. Can I go back to my cell now?
No, I just need to ask you a few more questions.
I've told this lot, I'm not talking to anybody unless it's Rob Hollins.
Yeah, not those sorts of questions. Just wondering how you were getting on. What's funny?
You think I'm mad, don't you?
I wouldn't put it quite like that.
I'll save you the hassle. Yeah, I'm mad. Raving loony. But I bet I'm no worse than you. So that's me. I'm just an average copper. But like I said, I've got experience on larger operations, working undercover and dealing with serious organised crime.
Yet here you are, walking the beat, still a lowly sergeant. What's the problem? Lack of ambition.
I enjoy being out in the real world, meeting people, getting my hands dirty.
Enjoys getting hands dirty.
I meant...
I know what you meant.
And yes, I do feel like I'm winding down rather than climbing up. All I want to do is my job and do it well.
You think you do your job well?
Yes. Why wouldn't I?
Oh, I've been looking at your record. A few little issues.
Issues? Like what?
Filing reports late, occasional tardiness.
Come on, are you telling me you've never filed a report
You're
late?
You're not talking about me.
This is ridiculous.
Problem, Sergeant.
Yes. I wasn't expecting the Spanish Inquisition.
Nobody does.
Yes, it's a very minor corneal abrasion. Don't think it requires any further intervention, but if it does hurt and there's some discharge, you do need to go to hospital.
Will do.
Why don't you take the rest of the day off?
I wish I could, but those ice creams won't sell themselves.
Well, I don't think an afternoon will make any difference.
I'm not giving him the satisfaction. That idiot might try to kill me, but he's not stealing my customers.
Mr. Jones, if you really believe that someone sabotaged your bicycle in order to injure you, you should go to the police.
Nah. Sooner deal with it myself. My brother won't know what's hit him.
What were the options again?
1 to 5. One being sad, 3 being neither happy nor sad, 5 being very happy.
Right in this moment or generally?
Just over the last week.
It's hard to say. Peaks and troughs, you know.
Go on.
Well, getting shot, that definitely knocked me down to a 3.
Fine. How good are you feeling about yourself? 1 feeling not so good, 5 feeling very good.
5. No, 4. I'm a bit peckish. Bacon sandwich, you go back up to a 5.
Just try something else, will you? What about your family?
What about yours?
That's not really how this works, is it?
How does it work? You try and get inside my head and trick me into a confession?
No, I was...
Look, we all have scars. You show me yours, I'll show you mine. What was it? Did you catch Mummy with the milkman? Or did Daddy hit you with the buckle end of the belt? Oh, I'm sorry. Was that a bit close? Look, I'll do a deal with you. You tell me all about it. And maybe I'll confess.
Tell you what, if you've got anything to confess, why don't you just tell it to Rob?
Rob?
Sergeant Hollins.
Oh, I know who he is. I just didn't know you were mates, that's all.
Come on, you know you want it. Yes. You're up, love.
Excuse me?
We've been through this. Customers respond to your feminine qualities.
Glad someone does. Like I said, I'm on strike.
Please.
Too late.
You cheeky little. What do you think you're doing?
Selling ice creams.
They were my customers.
Were they?
Just because you're dressed like a pirate doesn't mean to say you can act like one.
You want to have a chat about playing dirty? Who tampered with my brakes?
Who messed up my sign?
Who taped a rotten fish to the underside of my icebox?
Who in a rat did
I told you before I had nothing to do with... Rowan.
Get off me. I'm fine.
Fine? You can hardly stand, you great oaf.
What have you done to him?
Nothing.
So what happens next, sir?
Oh, I'm going to check up on a few things. I'll let you know if I need you.
You know, I have no agenda here. I just want to help, that's all. And if that means talking to Weston, fine. If not, fine. And despite what you might think, sir, I'm a good copper. You can ask anyone who works here.
That's exactly what I intend to do.
Oh, can I do anything?
Yeah, can you open the door, please?
You've done enough.
I'm not going anywhere till I know he's all right.
Oh, hi, mate.
Rob?
Sorry, love. I only just got your message.
So have you seen him?
No, not yet. The new super wanted to grill me. I think he started his career in Stasi.
So you still don't know who he is?
No, wish I did. Anyway, I'm fine.
Come back, or I was just starting to enjoy myself.
Sorry, love, but I've got to go. I'll call you later. Everything all right?
Yeah, fine.
You don't seem fine. Is it Weston?
Thought I told you to continue with normal duties.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing, sir.
Go on, then. How are you getting on?
Nearly there.
Any concerns? You've been in a little while.
I'd like to finish before I report back.
Don't suit yourself. Come and find me when you're done.
What were you doing when the chest pain started?
What he's always doing, arguing with his brother. They're like a pair of children.
What do you argue about?
We were never exactly close. But then our dad died and left me the ice cream van. Oshan thought he should have gone to him.
Why did he leave it to you?
Because he knew I'd do a better job. A van was his pride and joy. Since then, Oshan's been trying to put me out of business.
Any hope of a ceasefire?
Both too stubborn. This one won't even take a day off. Can't bear the thought of losing a single customer to his brother.
An ice cream man doesn't abandon his pets. I stood over my father's grave, and I promised I'd do him proud. Oshan started this war. I'm just trying to protect the family legacy.
Well, someone has to stop it. Right, chest pains. On a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being unbearable.
5. 7.
I'll call an ambulance.
You feeling all right? Seem a bit tense.
Just get us down, shall we?
How do you know Rob?
I work with him.
You remind me of a mate of mine. I met him inside.
All right, just a few more questions.
Nice bloke, bit weird. Emotional issues.
Do you have angry or violent thoughts?
Don't we all?
How often?
Hanged himself. Pity.
Did you just answer the question?
Well, easy, Tiger. Just having a nice little chat. You want to get those angry and violent thoughts under control.
We're done.
Don't be like that.
You're wasting my time.
Of course I am. Until they bring me Rob Hollins, I've got nobody to play with.
The ambulance service is still dealing with an accident on the ring road, so it might be a while.
Thank you, Karen. There goes my lunchtime trade. You know, all this could have been avoided. Rowan says you bear him a grudge.
Does he know?
You think you should have inherited the van.
I was the one that spent every summer working with Dad while Rowan was off doing his own thing. I was the one who looked after the van when Dad got sick, so yeah, I was hurt. Dad barely left me enough to buy that poxy bike. But I didn't start this feud, Rowan did.
How so?
Oh, he started getting paranoid, accusing me of all sorts. One day, he got it into his head I planted a dead rat in his freezer. Apparently, somebody called the council on him, said his van was unhygienic.
But it wasn't you?
Of course not.
Maybe you should tell him yourself. Before it's too late. Please, hear him out.
The rat was nothing to do with me. I wouldn't do that.
Got no interest in your lies.
I'm telling the truth. Do you really believe I'd want the council to shut you down? When I see that van, I see Dad.
You can't believe that he chose me. That I'm a better seller.
He felt sorry for you. When he died, you had handed out flyers for a living.
Shut up, the pair of you. Shut up. It was me. I put the blooming rat in the blooming freezer.
What? Why?
I thought the council would close you down and you'd be forced to sell up. I hate that stupid van.
You never said.
I tell you every day, you just don't listen. When we got married, we had plans to travel the world, go to festivals and events, do all sorts of things.
We went to that vendors' conference in Abergele.
That was years ago. What's the point in owning a mobile business when we've spent our whole lives in Leatherbridge Park? I can't do it anymore. And you're both wrong. Your Auntie Jill told me. Your dad wanted both of you to have a van.
That's not true. He chose me.
The plan was to leave Ocean money to buy a new one. He wanted you to work together, run your own fleet.
This a joke? I couldn't have got a rusty old banger with what he left me.
After all his treatment and the care home, the cash ran out. But by that point, Jill didn't have the art to tell him.
Why didn't you say something?
I couldn't do it to you. You seemed so happy that your dad had chosen you. But look at you now. Do him proud. If he could see you, both of you, the way you treat each other, he'd be ashamed.
Told you that rat weren't me.
Now, where have you been?
I popped out to get some lunch, sir. I've been 10 minutes.
Dr. Clay has something to tell us.
I've talked to Weston. In my opinion, he is sane.
Good, isn't it?
He's manipulative. He's indifferent to the feelings of others. He's adept at hiding his own emotions. And he displays all the classic hallmarks of a compulsive liar, so...
So what does he want?
Sir, don't know. Can't put my finger on it. He's got a plan and you're definitely part of it.
Did he give any reason why he wants to talk to me?
No, sorry.
Let's leave him to stew for today. I'll talk to my seniors, run this by them, get authority for extended detention.
Does that mean...
Since the manhunt, the media's been all over this. We're not making a move until my backside's covered. In the meantime, we get our evidence together, make sure you're properly briefed for interview.
So I am definitely going in?
I'll say this for you, Hollins. You keep your head when somebody's pressing your buttons. Let's hope you're not as stupid as you look.
Sorry I blamed you for the rat. And I shouldn't have tampered with your brakes. That was stupid.
Yeah, well, I shouldn't have messed with your sign. And when I paid those kids to egg the van, I didn't think they'd do it while you were still inside it.
Those little brats last week, you paid them.
Free ice creams.
I'm going to go home to pack.
What for?
I've spoken to the travel agents. Got myself a ticket on a Caribbean cruise. Leave tomorrow. Not sure when I'll be back.
By yourself?
You didn't want to come. I've wasted enough of my life waiting for you.
Wait. Where would you like to buy the van?
I can't afford it.
In installments, then? Well, I see it. Half of it belongs to you anyway.
You sure?
Absolutely. That is, if you'd have me as your travelling companion still.
What about hospital?
If they don't discharge me in time, I'll fly out and meet you.
I suppose there might be room in my cabin, if you ask me nicely.
What do you say?
Oh.
Come. Yes, Hollins.
What was all that about earlier on, sir? Testing me.
Does it matter?
I'd like to see Weston.
I told you.
I don't want to talk to him. I just want to see him. It'll help me prepare for the interview, get to know what I'm up against.
I don't want you face to face with him. Not till we've decided how best to handle this.
I understand that, sir, which is why I thought of a compromise.
I'll follow you to the hospital. Thank you.
for everything. And if you ever fancy a 99, you know where to find me.
It'll be on the house.
Thank you.
Now, you will make sure that Rowan is signed off by a cardiologist before you let him on the plane.
Between you and me, I haven't even booked the tickets yet. But don't worry, I'm definitely going. And I'll make sure he passes his medical first.
That's a relief. Try not to let him indulge too much whilst he's out there.
I'm hoping we can find a beach where there's not a single ice cream in sight. Though if we did, Rowan would probably want to open a snack bar there. Thank you for helping to knock their heads together. We'll send you a postcard.
All right. Let's do it. But if his face sparks anything in that melon of yours, even the haziest of hunches, I'm the first to know. Agreed?
Agreed.
Good. We've told him I'm going to talk him through his extended detention so he shouldn't suspect anything's up. I'll tell the custody sergeant to bring him through.
What do I have to do to get it into your skull? Tell me!
I'm sorry.
Fine.
Okay, thank you. It's Bridget Carmel and her daughter Lily.
Great, so now there's two patients.
Whoever this bloke is, he doesn't deserve this.
You'd better get that. See you up.
I can call them. What don't you understand? Get out!
I'm just trying
now!
Okay.
Next year on BBC.